Hey guys, welcome to my design pattern tutorial. I'm Ripon Dotto. This is my second tutorial on design pattern. Today I'm gonna show you the singleton pattern. So in software engineering, the singleton pattern is a design pattern that restricts the instantiation of a class to one object. This is useful when exactly one object is needed to coordinate actions across the system. This concept is sometimes generalized to systems that operate more efficiently when only one object exists. So let's look at the UML diagram. This is singleton UML diagram. Instance, which is a private singleton, and get instance, we'll get the instance. That's it. So now let's get started with the Visual Studio. Take a project, console application, give the application name singleton lab or whatever you want. Alright, so let's take a class. Let's say singleton public. So first I need private singleton. Instance, and we must have a private constructor. Then public singleton. Let's say get instance or only instance. So it will return the instance. Now let's instantiate the main class. So singleton instance equal new singleton. Now you can see singleton is inaccessible due to its protection level, because here is a private constructor. So that means we cannot instantiate that class. So how can we get the instance? Well, we can get the instance from the instance method, but in order to get that instance method without instantiation, how can we get it? We have to make it public, static, right? So that means we have to make that instance also static. Now we can get the instance, right? So we can even check it. Before going to check, we need to check that instance is created or not. So if the instance is null, so instance equal new singleton. Okay. So you can run. So we can add a constructor message. Let's say instance is created. So you can see instance is created. Now how can we verify that? Let's say we have another instance which is instance 2. So and console read key. Alright, start. Now you can see instance is created, which is only one type, because instance is created for the first instance. Whenever it is going to create another instance, on that time it will check that instance is not null, which is already created. So it will, the second time it will just simply return the first instance. That means our instance, I mean our class is now singleton. Alright, so now our class is now a singleton, but this is not a thread shape, because whenever we are going to use it in a multi-thread application, on that time many thread, I mean there is a chance to create many thread the same instance again and again, more than one time. So how can we protect this? So in this case, right, so in this case I want to add another variable, private static read only object, let's say mutex equal new object. So a mutex is an object that allows multiple threads to synchronize access to a shared resource, and this mutex has two states, one is locked, another one is unlocked. Once a mutex has been locked by a thread, other threads attempting to lock it will block. When the locking thread unlocks, I mean releases, then other threads, I mean one of the blocked threads will lock it and proceed the operation. So lock mutex. And now that means whenever there is a multiple thread, only first thread can have the chance to get into the this line. That means first thread can instantiate the singleton. Whenever it is releases, then other thread may attempt. So on the time we can check again, we can double check instance equal null, then we will instantiate the singleton. That means first thread will enter and other threads will be blocked. If instance is null, then it will instantiate, and finally it will release the lock. Then other threads, one of the other thread will enter and it will check if instance is null, then. So since the instance is already created, instantiated, so second instance will not create the instance anymore. So this is now thread safe. So our singleton class is now thread safe. We can use in a multi-thread application. Singleton can be used in the abstract factory, builder and prototype patterns as in their implementations. For example, you can use the singleton pattern as a logger, logging. So that means in an application only one login can attempt the whole operation. Thank you very much for watching this tutorial. If you like this tutorial, don't forget to subscribe this channel and make a positive comment in the comment box. In next tutorials, I'm gonna show you some different design patterns. So see you soon. Bye bye.